Guys, so check it out. Man, I was at this crazy party this weekend, and I met this fat girl, man. She was just the greatest thing ever. Oh my gosh, I love the party life, man. This place is the best thing that's ever happened to me, man. There ain't nothing better than a good party, a good girl, and a good night with that girl. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? Like, I love my beer too, man. You know what I'm saying? Oh my gosh, dude. I'm tripping. I gotta go, man. I'll see y'all later.
So, I was really skeptical about coming on this show and living with all these people in this house, but it's been so great since I've been here. Last night, I went to this bar, and I met this wonderful guy named Fernando. He and I had a couple of appletinis, and we just talked the night away. It was so good to finally find someone that shared my views.
Oh my gosh, I'm gonna call him right now.
So he's been married 5 times, divorced 4 of them, still with one. He has one child with one wife, another child with another wife, me with another wife, nobody with the other one, she was a witch kind of person, you know, that kind of thing. And then 2 with this one. He's totally turned his life around, everything like that, good, great, whatever like that. But he was never there for me. Now he's trying to be there for the other two and he expects me to support that. There's no way. Can you believe you tried to talk me out of coming here? I mean, it's like one of the best experiences I could ever have. Listen to my voice. Excuse me. He even gave me a gift before I came here. But I'm not going to open it. I'm not going to touch it. I might just burn it in a few hours. Who knows what I'll do. We'll just have to see. Who does he think he is? Telling me I can't come here, or I shouldn't come here. Just because he's all holier than thou now, he thinks that he can tell me what to do and tell me that this is right for me and that's right for me and everything like that. All this crap. But I'm the one that's making the decisions in my life. I'm the one that can decide to be in a place like this. Yeah, everybody's a whore, everybody's gay, everybody's everything, getting mad, it's a big bunch of drama, it's not exactly the best outlook on life for people, but whatever.
In order to reach a state of peace, one must let go of everything. That is what I learned from the temple this weekend. And next weekend, I will go worship the Christian God. You see, people, you must not worship just one God, but many other gods to find the right one. And in order to find that true God, you must have evidence. And with evidence, you'll find the answer. You see, you must continue the search and continue. No stop. And you must look deep into other religions. You must look at the Quran, for example. You must look into history. Look into the books. Study philosophy. Study and study until you find the answer. I have read many books. But one that captured me was a Plato's cave. You see, people, we are locked, we are trapped in this cave, and we must reach that light, then we must find that peace. And that's only through your search and letting go of everything. Let me get back to my meditation.
Do you want something in your Sprite? No? And we don't even have any Sprite.
Hey, Lou, you get the drinks, man?
Yes.
Lou, hey, Lou, I need that, man. Come back with that.
Oh, sorry about that.
Oh, hold on. Let me get the phone, man. Go fix the drinks, dude. Hello? Hey, Elizabeth.
What?
It's your mom. Hey, she's coming. Stop feeding the cat and get your mom's on the phone.
No. This is your mom.
What class is this?
Okay. Sorry to call you now, but your dad died.
What?
You what? Okay, bye.
Dearest Elizabeth, I pray that this book will change your life as it did mine. Love, Dad.
Alright, man, whatever.
Hey, guys, you
guys
need to look at this.
Yeah, right. Whatever.
Whatever.
You gotta be kidding me.
Did she find peace?